Alright, what's up guys? Today we're going to be doing another install, but today on a different car. We're going to be doing it on my mate Kyle's Hilux. This is Kyle.
Hey, young guys.
Yeah, he owns a, what is it?
2004 Hilux.
So we're actually going to be buying a subwoofer today. We don't know which one we want to get, but that's what we're going to do. We're going to go down to the Super Cheap Auto or Autobahn or something like that and see what speakers we want to put in. We have a problem because his car has a really small space for a sub. So we're going to have to find a sub that's really slim to fit behind the back seats. So I'll show you what it's like. It's pretty small. So we have to try and fit a sub right in there, and there's not much space.
The building is on fire!
As you can see, there's not enough bass in this fucking music. So we're gonna get the sub in the back.
So none of us actually have our licenses yet, so we're gonna have to ride our bikes down to the shops, which is gonna be difficult trying to bring the sub back, but we don't have a choice. So we've got the new kicker Comp RT. It's like a slim build. It's a 12-inch subwoofer, and yeah, we're gonna unbox it. So they come with a couple of brackets.
No.
What it came for.
Alright, so that's the sub. Let's install it.
No, I just need to cut that out.
Yeah. I think what we're going to do, we're going to cut a rectangle section out of this bar. That way we might be able to push the sub back in more, and then this thing will close.
And we're going to cut this thing off the bottom so it's sitting flat. The thing is going to straight cut.
What if we cut that?
It just come loose.
Bend it down.
Yeah, we'll
just
hit it.
Oh yeah, so we'll cut this thing off just so that it sits flush.
So we bought a US Audio digital amplifier to power the sub. 2000 watt max, mono, so it'll only power one sub. So yeah, we'll unbox this now. Screws and tools. And then you get a bass dial with it and a connector. And then you get your amplifier. Where are we going to put that at?
Cut that off maybe. The sub can sit flat. So we're going to be cutting this bar out of the way so that the sub can sink in further. So whatever you do, don't do it like we are. We're being idiots and smashing it because it's like tackling it. We can't figure out how to get it off. Oh my god, it's so hot.
Oh, you need a bucket.
So we've cut as much as we can away. So, fingers crossed. Yes!
So we've got an 8 gauge 2 channel wiring kit. Fucking yeah. We're taking the plastic covers off to get to the back of the head unit, so we're able to connect the wires to the amplifier.
Alright, So that's what we needed to get to. The REM out. Now we can connect the sub to the head unit. Oh, we have power.
Oh.
There it is, now it's on.
I just turned it on.
There we go. So...
Ah, can't fire.
Nothing.
No?
Nothing.
At all?
No.
I'm a fucking block of shit, guys. Now lift it away. It goes boom.
Oh. Hmm. So what we did, we didn't know this, but we connected it to the power cable of the head unit and it wasn't giving the sub enough power, so we didn't know what was wrong with it. So what we're going to do, drag it through the firewall, up through and connect it to the battery and hopefully we get all the power. Fingers crossed this works. It's taken us forever, but hopefully it works. Ready?
She take my money, well I'm in need. Yeah, she's a trifling friend indeed. Oh, she's a gold digger, way over town, that digs on me.
So we finished the sub installation, we put it all in. Took a while, it's kind of dark outside now. So, what do you think about it? Do you like it?
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, so remember to like and comment and please subscribe because I'm trying to get to 50 subs at the moment. So if you could, just leave a sub. And we'll see you for the next one. See ya. When you turn it on, it has to be genuine.